Hey, what's poppin' with you, though? It's your boy, Caro, and we are back for yet another episode of Pokken Tournament Online Ranked Batches. So you see me use my boy Pikachu or battling against Jin, a C1 Sceptile from Canada, Quebec, with a 51.30% win ratio. My win ratio took a drop. I used to be at like 60 or like 60, 61, and I'm at all the way down to 55. That's because I decided to take Sceptile into ranked match to see how well I could do, and I nearly lost my B5 rank like 4 times in a row. I had to go back to Pikachu every single time I almost lost it, so. Either way, we're with Pikachu right now. Again, this is pre-recorded, so all these battles have already been done. And you see, I try to use the counter there, it's not working. And he also reveals that he is definitely the type of Sceptile to keep his range. You see, he's backing up this entire time. He's not getting into my face, and if I try to get into his face, he uses his counter. So he really likes staying away, and you know what? If I'm a Pikachu, I can stay away just as well. I tried grabbing Bear twice, and honestly didn't work, so he got the grab off on me, which absolutely sucks. I'm just waiting for him to just get close. His little magical leaks tried to get me, but because I was hitting him, they disappeared. Great use of Rotom there by him, because I was in the air right there. There's nothing I could do to evade that Rotom. He kicks me into the lead seat and gets that combo off, and it was honestly very nice to combo on him. One thing you also see in this video is that I'm not using my Cresselia Reshiram. I'm using Frogadier and I believe it's Eevee. I have Frogadier and Eevee whenever I decided to use Machamp, but I decided, hey, you know what? Let me try it with Pikachu and see how it works. But either way, I tried my special off, didn't work, and he's able to get the win off on me. But you know what's not done yet? We're going to be using Eevee, get that nice HP boost, get that nice attack boost, helping hand. We know we out here double battles. So you know what? He gets the Bullet Seed off on me. I'm surprised he didn't use Leaf Storm, but either way, he is going to get that grab on me right there. It's not looking too good. I have yet to damage him, and he's setting up all his traps. He uses Togekiss, and look at this man run. This man is going all over the place. I just hit him with a clean Electro Ball. Just hopefully that will calm him down a little bit. See, Mega Evolves new Mega Sceptile with the Speed Boost, which is horrifying. I use Eevees. I need that attack bonus. I'm not sure why I shielded there. I should have definitely ran up and grabbed him with Nuzzle. It, at the very least, just not my normal grab, but you know what? I decided to let him sit there. The Bullet Seeds are going to get me as I'm now in my burst as well. He runs up and grabs me. Beautiful grab on his part. I'm at 140, but I do have the attack bonus while he's at 372. 77 HP left. It's not looking too good. I used my Volt Shock Fist to get close. I don't care. That's actually not going to work. 37 HP left. I use my counter. I try to get him on the upbound, but it doesn't work. Use Thunder. Hit him with the Nuzzle. And I'm going to be able to just barely take that win. So I saw, you know what? Eevee's attack bonus probably helped me out there. Let me grab Eevee again, because Eevee is definitely putting in that work. Knew he's going to try to tap me right there, so I go with that little... It would be super armor or counterattack in this game, technically. He tries to grab me, but I'm technically still in the hit frames, so you can't grab someone if they're still in the hit frames. That's what I found out the hard way. So, for example, if you use Cubone Diglett, which is a very good support set, I hope you do use it sometimes. If you use that support set and you try to use Cubone to like hit your opponent so they're just constantly guarding and you get the grab off, it's not gonna work like that, because as long as they're in the hit frames, it's not gonna work. So, either way, he's Mega Sceptile. I'm normal Pikachu, but I do get my burst off right here. Then I use Eevee to get my attack bonus, because you know, we gotta do this stuff right here. We're at 49 HP left, he's at 444. It's not looking too good, so I'm just, I have the shield, because he has all of this stuff open right here. Wait for my chance to get in. Use Thunder there. Use the Volt Shock Fist, still gonna be guarded. I go after his Detect so he doesn't get me. Get in with a nice clean combo to finish up the game. So with that, that is gonna be the first match. 4 minutes into this video, so you know, it's a decently long match. Decently long for Pikachu versus Sceptile. I'm also going to be skipping out all the transitions between matches in this game, in this video, just because they took a long time for me to get these matches. I was sitting here waiting in the CPU match for like 30 seconds before I got another challenger. So, in a couple more seconds after we press OK here, listen to Nia go on and not blah blah blah, we're going to be cutting to the next match. Who's against the Garchomp, an A4 Garchomp, and I'm B5, so this guy, he is a lot higher ranked than me. He's the awakened one. Boss Hog at A4, and I'm sitting here at B5. Holy crap, rating system. Y'all want to see me get my ass kicked. 1,354 battles. But you know what? We're using Pikachu. We obviously know. Competitive Pokemon trainer. Electric beats ground. That's a joke. Electric does not do well against ground, but you know what? Doesn't matter either way, because this is Pokken and not main series Pokemon. So I'm still going to be able to hit him with my Thunders and my Electro Balls. Use my counter there, try to get him with the aerial homing attack, but I luckily get out of the way of his one, and I can get him with an attack. He tries to jump there, so I just send an Electro Ball. Try to go with the grab, it's not gonna work. This guy is attacking me right now. Get that grab off. And also, you'll see here, I'm using... In my previous videos, when I hit people with my counter, and they were just doing that little, like, I'm falling to the ground animation, I just let them fall. Now I'm actually attacking them while... they're following, because I know that I can do that now, and it's a great way to rack up damage, because it's free damage. Free attacks. Either way, I say it's the first match against Boss Hog. Pretty handily, to be honest. I only took about 100-something damage. Let's see if he can bring it back this game. He has 666 health. I just realized how bulky Garchomp is in this game. Either way, I used my counter there. I didn't take any damage, but unfortunately, I do miss it. But I am going to be able to get him into the dual phase. I don't know much about Garchomp, but I do know I hate that attack, so I was just attacking the moment I saw him get close to me, because I knew he was going to use that grab. It's a very, very good grab, to be honest. I also don't like Stone Edge, because Stone Edge is also a really freaking good grab. It acts as a counterattack, and if you hit them during the Stone Edge preparation, then they use the Stone Edge on you, and then they get to grab you, and oh, it is horrible. You try to do it there again, but you know what? We're in a burst mode, hit it up into the air, Thunderbolt them. I tried to grab, but didn't work. As you saw, I tried to use my special the moment I saw him in the air, but unfortunately, he hit me before the actual special animation could go through. And he's just gonna slash and stomp me right into the wall, and he's gonna take that game. So, we're gonna use the Frogadier. I don't think I actually used Frogadier yet, so... Well, I mean, I've used him, but I haven't actually used the care, like the support, so... Either way, he goes burst mode very, very quickly, if you ask me. I jump because I know he's going to be using his special. I'm going to get some quick Thunderbolt on him for quick damage, but I forgot how long it takes for the freaking spec. Like, you know how Garchomp, when he does his special, if you miss it, he does, like, that big roar? Then you can always get a couple of free hits on him during that roar. I forgot how long that actually lasts, so I went for a third Thunderbolt, and I should have just stuck with it, too. To let him get some damage off on me. Either way, I'm at 447 health, or 340 health, mind me. Excuse me. Well, he's at 34 health. It's looking pretty freaking good right now, but he gets the grab on me, and holy, that grab just brought it all back. I use my special here, but he unfortunately has the jump. Huge Frogadier, as he's his Quagsire. And then he's going to hit me right through the Quagsire's Mud Bomb, and it's going to take me out, so... I almost beat someone who was A4 while I'm B5, and you know what? The fact that I came that close, it makes me happy. I'll take that L handily. Because you know what? I only lost 50 points. I'll take that L. That was definitely a good game, Boss Hog, if you're watching this, which I doubt you are, but if you are... You're a freaking great-ass Garchomp. Grade A Garchomp, you know what I'm saying? A4? He's definitely a grade A Garchomp because he is an A rank. So either way, I had to skip a little bit right there because I ended up getting a battle with a Gengar who literally lagged the entire match. Literally just lagged the entire match, and I ended up losing because I literally could not do anything. Like, I used Thunderbolt. I was trying to use Thunder, and I kept on coming out as Thunderbolt, so it wouldn't register the jump. Like, it was that horribly laggy, and I'm not gonna make you guys watch a battle that went on for like 7 minutes, because you know when the match is lagging, the timer's even going down slower. So, either way, we're battling Obito. But if you guys are like, oh, he doesn't upload losses or anything like that, just mark that down as a loss of this video. So we're at one win. No, we're at two wins. No. For one win, two losses. There we go. So I lost against Boss Hog and I lost against that Gengar. But I did beat the Sceptile, so. Either way, now we're battling Obito, the B4 Lucario. Uses extreme speed, which people say that's not a safe move. That's an extremely safe move. I don't know how you can even freaking say that's not a safe move. Extreme speed is safe as hell in Lucario. Either way, I just jump right up, use Nuzzle. And I tried to get him with a little arrow attack, but he got me with the extreme speed. I tried to get him with my Iron Tail, but it's not working. He uses the Force Palm, is doing a ton of freaking damage as I Mega Evolve. Well, he can do this Mega Evolve. We get our burst mode open. Hit him with their charge attack. I tried to use my burst because by reading what this guy was doing earlier, every single time I went for an attack and I failed it, he would end up using his counter there. He uses extreme speed there, but it's not going to work as I use my counter and it is going to take him the first match. So that's another thing you'll see. Since that Gengar fight, after the whole loss, I actually ended up getting kicked off the freaking rank service. I guess the lag was so bad you disconnected or something like that. And I accidentally crushed my Cresselia Crusheram. That is some pokey fusion shit right there. Crusheram. Either way, I take my Cresselia now. Oh my god, I can't speak. Reshiram and Cresselia, because they're on the slot A, like the very first slot. I was just spamming the A buttons. I wanted to get back to recording. So that's why I'm using these two now instead of the Eevee from the I was using earlier. I'm honestly not sure which one I like better, because I know, I mean, I am horrible at this. Cresselia, holy god. It gives me my burst gauge very fast, and it also heals me a lot, and it takes away any negative stat conditions I might have. And you see I backed up right there, because I saw how many times this guy was going for his freaking, what's it called, extreme speed. So I'm like, okay, if he's going to keep on going for extreme speed, we got to keep on freaking backing up for this guy. He uses Diglett. I'm backing up. You ain't getting close to me with that Mega Lucario. You're using all those Aura Spheres you want, but you're not getting close to me with that Mega Lucario boy. There's Electro Ball. I run straight up to him. Didn't give a crap. I jump. Use Thunder. Instantly go with the guards. I know he's going to try to use his special there. As I get him with the Bolt Tackle and take the game. I also, nothing I realized while playing these matches, while I was playing matches, while I wasn't recording something like that, is that Volt Tackle is essentially the same as Lucario's E-Speed, where it's a pretty safe move on Wake Up. Like, it's Pikachu's essential Wake Up move. And that's what I need to remember, too, is that when I'm down, and I don't want people using their grabs on me, or if I don't want people to use their counterattacks on me or anything like that, Volt Tackle is great. Unfortunately, you can't use it on stuff like Mewtwo, because if Mewtwo uses his Psy Strike, which gives him all that super armor, you're just going to be sitting there in the air defenseless while he gets that freaking Psy Strike on you. But a lot of characters like Lucario or Pikachu Libre or anything like that, you're going to just use Volt Tackle to get right out of there. The only bad thing is that you're going to be put into the air afterwards, so. But either way, 12 minutes into this video, and we're going to be playing Austin, a B5 Mewtwo, 54.21% win ratio from the United States, Ohio, pulling all the Magikarp, Austin, pulling all the Magikarp, all the Magikarp. I choose you, Pikachu, we're wearing the same clothes we always do, and we're going to be picking Cresselia, because I barely use Reshiram. Even before the patch, I barely use Reshiram. And this guy's Mewtwo is a lot different than other Mewtwos I've played, because you'll notice this guy is very long distance. He does not, like you guys, how I talk about how the Sceptile doesn't approach at all. This guy does not approach with his Mewtwo at all. He uses the little Icicle Spheres, and then uses Hyper Beam right afterwards. Icicle Spear, Icicle Spear, Hyper Beam. Icicle Spear, Hyper Beam. That's how he plays. And you know what? It's sad because, honestly, it's hard to adapt against, because despite Hyper Beam being the game's way of basically being like, oh, Hyper Beam is this completely unsafe move from Mewtwo, because even though it's super powerful and you can hit it across the freaking stage. Also, by the way, that was freaking insane. He used Hyper Beam. I just charged right into it, punched through it, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Fist going through that Kamehameha wave. But either way, what I was saying before, Hyper Beam. The game's like, okay, Hyper Beam is this extremely slow move, it's super strong, goes across the stage, but you know, it's extremely punishable, it's the startup lag, and then the end lag, and all that stuff. Half of that is freaking not true at all. Because, you know what? Hyper Beam, yes, there's startup lag, but it lifts Mewtwo up into the air, so if you use any ground attack, such as Pikachu's Thunderbolt, or you're using your crouched, or your low stance attack, or anything like that, or even if your character uses low attacks for their normal neutral game, you're gonna miss, because Mewtwo's suddenly in the air. Even though you're right up in front of him, you can't hit him with that. If you try to grab him while he's doing that, again, he's in the air technically, so you can't even grab him. You can't attack him up front. So he can charge a Hyper Beam directly in your face, and there's nothing you can do about it unless you're attacking high. Also, what you're going to see here is that for this match, a lot of times I'm running right up to him and using counterattack, because I notice every single time this guy wakes up, he instinctively goes for Side Strike. So I'm like, you know what? The best way to use the beat a Side Strike is by using your counterattack. So either way, he doesn't use it. That time he's the Fire Ice Thunder Punch combo, but it doesn't work for him. I get up close to him. He uses his little combo. I burst mode. He Mega Evolves. You know what? Here's the thing. I love tricking out Mega Mewtwo's like this as well, because Mewtwo's special is a grab. So as long as you're up in his face like that, it's going to hit, but if you jump and you're not on the ground, it's not going to hit. So what I love doing is running up to Mewtwo and then instantly jumping, or jumping and then jumping again, because they'll use their special, waste it, and then they'll be sitting there as a defenseless duck. So either way, we beat Austin right there, get 100 points. But either way, what I was saying is like, yeah, you can do all this stuff, but Hyper Beam goes through it. It's quote-unquote end lag is like half a second at most. So it's not even extremely punishable, because half the time they're doing it across the stage. Like, it's weird. Either way, we're battling Austin again. We just battled him. We're battling him again because, you know what? That's how the rank system works. If you just keep on going right fast, you're gonna, like, if you, like when he's like, oh, you did so good. Oh, you were a Magikarp out of water. Oh, yeah, you did great. You're a master in the making. When you're doing, when she's going through all that, and you just keep on spamming A, and you press A for the next battle, and the other person's doing that same thing, good chance you're gonna fight the same person again. So, either way, we're battling Austin again. Second game against him, we know how he plays. Icicle Spear, Hyper Beam. And that's another thing I have to do. That's my fault right there, because every single time he goes for that Hyper Beam, I'm trying to use my aerial homing attack, and I just land straight into the Hyper Beam. So he's a little aerial counter, I use my counter. And I just see how much rank my attacks had. Use my counterattack there, but unfortunately it does not work, as his little ice fire punch goes right through it. And right here, I'm just trying to approach. So it might seem like I'm spamming a little bit, but I'm just trying to approach. Yeah, I used my counterattack there, because I was predicting him to slash strike, but I did it a little too early, so unfortunately it doesn't work. Hyper Beam on the wake up, you're not going to get me with that, as I use Cresselia, and right after that, he's going to use his own Cresselia. Because I think he does again in this match too, because I guess when I use Cresselia, he wants to use it because he's feeling pressured or something. Either way, use my counterattack to get in. Use counterattack again there, so he's just shielding now. He wants to see what I'm going to be doing. I'm perfectly okay with that because it was doing chip damage to him. It's right there, I dropped my shield, I wasn't expecting him to do that again, and he takes that game, so. Either way, pick Cresselia again. We need that HP bonus. We don't need Reshiram, because honestly, Reshiram would not be doing well against this guy unless I got him in the air when he's using Icicle Spears. But again, I know how he plays right here, so that's why I use the freaking Electro Ball first thing to hit him, because I know he was going to jump. There, two Hyper Beams, nothing I could do about it, because if I jumped, I might have got hit by it. If I tried to run up and grab him, I would have got hit by it. If I tried to use Thunderbolt, I would have got hit by it. So, for a move that's not supposed to be safe, it's pretty damn safe. Either way, kudos to Austin right here, because I was using that counter, like, right across into his face all that time, and he finally decides to grab me for it. He uses Hyper Beam. I'm going to counter with Thunder, so I was actually able to get a nice chance to do it this time. Grab him there, but there's the Side Strike, so I should have kept on counter-attacking. Either way, I have enough energy for the burst mode, and the match isn't in my favor right now, so gonna use Thunder to get up close to him, Thunderbolt to change the phase, and now we're gonna go into the burst mode to heal off that damage as well, as he just uses Hyper Beam, puts me all the way back down to where I was before. I tried to use Thunder there, but unfortunately he registers as a Thunderbolt, and he's able to get me with that Hyper Beam and take the game. So right here, I was like, okay, we lost. I don't think I should need, I didn't need to lose this guy. I was definitely, he was just spamming the Azul Spear and Hyper Beam. I don't need to lose this guy. Let me get this guy again, rank match. Let me get this guy again. I want to battle this guy and beat his ass, and that is who we get. So let's see if your boy Kero can bring this back. So we beat Austin once, Austin beat us once. Austin, it's time to get that ass beat. Bring that ass over here, boy. All right. looking like a Mewtwo-ass-looking nigga. So we're gonna get that boy. We're gonna get you, Awesome. We're gonna get you for that last match. Either way, Icicle Spear, Hyper Beam. That's my fault. I tried to counter the Hyper Beam for some reason. It's not gonna work, obviously. Hyper Beam again. I'm out of his range. He uses Hyper Beam again. Again, he does not like to. He's not like to approach at all. He honestly, again, he's B5, so he's definitely a decent player, but Austin is extremely readable. So again, if you're watching this, Austin right here, you do have to work on that kind of game because you are extremely easy to read. Because it's Side Strike on Wake Up, Icicle Spear, then Hyper Beam from far away, and that's about it. There hasn't been really anything else except for one or two Ice Punches. So like, you're right up close to him as he uses Hyper Beam. As Icy Thunder, is he gonna get me with that combo? But I do have my burst. He uses Rush Ram right here. It's not gonna work on me because I do have my burst and get right through Rush Ram to the little blue flare. I use my attack and I go answering the Volt Shock Fist. Absolutely 100% knowing that he's rather gonna use Hyper Beam or Side Strike. It was probably Side Strike because, you know, he loves to use Side Strike. But you know what? Our Volt Shock is gonna go right through that and catch him. Gotta catch him all, Pokemon. Hey! We're still not going out here. I immediately go for the freaking Electro Ball, because again, this guy leads off the map the exact same way. He jumps up, uses the Icicle Spear, so I'll just use my anti-air Electro Ball as fast as I can. I roll away, because I'm like, okay, you know what? This guy's definitely going to be trying to use that Side Strike. Let me just roll away. And he uses Hyper Beam directly in my face. The gall of this guy. Hyper Beaming in a Pikachu's face, even though I do mess up my combo there. And right here, he's gonna notice me doing that. He adapts. He grabs me. So you know what? That's a good play on his part, because you know I was doing the same thing over and over again. And he decided to take up action and do something different than the Icicle Spear Hyper Beam. Right there, he also tried to use the Fire Spin, but that's not gonna be working on me, boy. Because he's at 129 HP, I'm at 418. He uses Hyper Beam once again, as I'm gonna run up to him as he uses Side Strike, and I'm gonna use the counter for the game. So these matches get awesome. We're definitely a way to show you guys that you have to adapt to your opponent, where Austin was constantly using Icicle Spear Hyper Beam. If you get up into his face, he was using Side Strike. If you knocked him down and got up into his face, it was Side Strike. Matt, you know what? That's just how you had to play. He waited for me to approach every single time. He never, ever approached me, unless you count the time where he used like Fire Punch, Ice Punch. So, either way, that is going to be the video for this. The video for today in the online matches for this video. So I do hope you guys enjoyed. I definitely enjoyed these matches. They were freaking great matches, except for that Gengar match that I had to cut out because it's honestly just Ebola. So like, comment, subscribe. Kirokiro Studio, we are trying to get to 700 subscribers. So if you guys can do me a favor and share this video around, or even if you don't want to share this video, share the Pokken Tournament playlist around on other Pokken Tournament groups on Facebook or Twitter or anything like that. Share it around, get us to 700 subscribers, and that'd be peachy. Like, comment, subscribe, Kirokiro Studio, and I'm out.